500, 400, 300, 200, 100, 50, 20.
Skinheads in the 1990s. I think 1995 is when the first major Florida boys started coming out, so you know, they were very quickly onto this. Since 9/11, we have mostly focused on so-called Muslim groups. This idea that if they have access to these communications tools, their movement will spread. There was no concern. Movement that calls itself the alt-right. Some of them are jackbooted thugs. Some of them are people who want to get into street fights and they have swastika tattoos and they, you know, are skinheads, you know, that kind of thing. But the more savvy ones, the ones who frankly are able to have more of an impact, are the ones who, you know, they wear suits, they wear ties, they don't have any visible tattoos. They just want to talk about ideas, right? That's their posture.
Placed on utility poles, these small stickers carry an unfamiliar message. Under a teal triangle with three lines that join in the middle are the words Identity Europa, or a group founded in 2016 that believes America was not intended to be a multiracial society. On the Southern Poverty Law Center's website, it's been designated a hate group.
Identity Europa was a group that wanted to be the advocates for white people. They try to avoid white power. They try to say, we are people of European heritage who want to be proud of our heritage. They will say, yes, I want a white ethnostate, but I don't need for there to be a war. If people are willing to go peacefully, I would prefer it. People like Jared Taylor, people like Richard Spencer, they will say, well, look, this could be peaceful. Like, Richard Spencer actually used the phrase peaceful equipment to describe his vision. Decision, and if you start taking these people on their own terms, you start to buy into the cult.
So I applied to Identity Europa, it was like Christmas Eve, and I didn't tell Richie for maybe like a day or two, and he confessed to me, he was like, yeah, I'm jealous, I wish I thought of joining first, it seems like a great group. So he sent them an application. New Year's Eve. You know, what's your name or pseudonym? Do you have any visible tattoos? Are you of European non-Semitic heritage? That was like one of their questions. What are your thoughts on the JQ? What are your thoughts on the Jewish question?
There has been this overriding theory within these hardcore white nationalist groups called the Jewish question since, you know, hardcore version of the JQ, which is, let's exterminate them. She's not supposed to say that. She's supposed to say, Jews are not white, and in the ultimate dystopian version of our desired society, which is a white ethnic state, Jews will not be welcome. And so the debate within the opera is between peaceful separation from the Jews and extermination. There is no life on the other side.
The Jewish question that's very fine as propagated by if a euphemistic way of asking, are you anti-Semitic and are you inaugurated in January.
We, the citizens of America, are now joined in a great national effort to rebuild our country and restore its promise for all of our people.
And all this stuff that seemed fringe actually very directly connected to the dead center of our politics and of our society.
Donald Trump's movement, whether Kellyanne Conway wants to admit it or not, was fundamentally about identity. It was about identity for white people.
Rural America spoke up when they elected Trump. Rural America. ready for back to school with Going, Going, Gone no. and Dick's Sporting Goods. Shop up to 70% off thousands of styles of athletic apparel and footwear from top brands with new markdowns every week. Before they're gone, get going and save.
Hail our people, hail victory!
Systems damage. In February of 2016, there was a
500, 400, 300, 200, 100, 430. Systems damaged.
I guess this could be the end of the series.